Alright everybody, here's Baron Sun's 117B that I modified. They originally come with these super chintzy zinc handles where if they look at concrete they break into 1,000,000,000,000 pieces. They like to crack right around here. And so I swapped it out for some aluminum handles. They actually fit. It's actually a very, very close fit. Took a little modification, but it was easy. I have my camera stooping, stops recording. I was gonna show you the tang pin. The Baron Sun's Barops tang pins are crap. There are these tiny little things. It's kind of like an imaginary tang pin. It thinks it's doing something, but it's actually not. All it does is eat into the handles and look like something that doesn't do shit. So I drilled out the blade. I grounded out the Dremel. It didn't have any carbide bits. Grounded out a little bit bigger. It's about 4 millimeters, 3.9 millimeters, and put in my own tang pin that actually works, kinda. The pins on the trainer handles, it was one of these trainers. Very, very close in handle size, by the way, if you're wondering. Extremely close. The Barops pins are actually thinner than the trainer, so I had to grind out the blade a little bit bigger. Not much. It's a little bit bigger to slide the pins through, and it actually works. Now the spacing in here, it's actually bigger, just a little bit bigger than the Barops or Baron Sun's handles. So I just doubled up on the washers, the bushings. So the ones that came with the trainer and the ones that came on the original setup, the original hardware, I just combined it. So it needs a little bit of fine tuning, like for tolerance. It doesn't quite close. But cutting away at the inside here, I probably can make this clear because the blade hits inside. Okay, my camera's off recording again. The blade stops, it hits right here, and it hits right in there. So if I just grind that down with a Dremel or a thin file, I can probably make that work, make it actually lock on close. It flips decently, besides being kind of sloppy. Actually flips half decent. It weighs 0.2 ounces less. It went from 5.8 to 5.6 ounces like this. It feels much better in the hand. Just these ones, they're rounded, but it just a little grabby, and you drop it, it's gonna break. This, not gonna break. So you wanna make a good beater for cheap, this is what you do. I need a little advice on this. Despite having a thicker tang pin, it's larger in diameter, I'm having that go on. Because the distance between the pins is actually increased slightly, the holes are a little bit farther apart than when this was. So a little, if you know how to fix that, post in the comments, shoot me a message. I would love to hear from you. And if it fixes it, I'll give you a shout out in the next video on part two if I get this thing working good. Other than that, I mean, it's really, it does all right. I mean, it flips as you'd expect. Anyways, thanks for watching.